She got the life she wanted, but now all she does is cry. So take what you want, take what you can, take what you please. Don't give a damn, ask for forgiveness, never permission. Take what you want, take what you can, take what you please. Don't give a damn, it's in the blood, and this is tradition. Standing behind them,
or you're sitting behind them, or sitting behind them, or sitting behind them, or sitting behind them, all the way up there at the top. When this chorus drops, I need to see everybody move their body, whether you jump, you move your arms. I need to see that you have the energy that's gonna last you a 2-hour set. Because I've got the energy, do you? I'm gonna give you one more try. You ready to do that again? Okay, I believe in you. One, two, three.
Thank you.
type shit, alright? This is a demo off my last album, but I just love it so fucking much.
Yeah, I know. The fights of my soul. I don't believe in love any longer, cause love don't believe in me. She's out of reach, like a coin in the street, and I'm tired of being on my feet. Hopeless devotion, a fickle emotion, conditioned perfection reverse. I bet over under, I'll hopelessly wonder, if not here, then where will I go? I don't believe in justice no longer, cause just wasn't made just for me. How can I help when my brain named itself? If I'm so smart, then why do I need this grave explanation, narrated translation, location for opening wide? Masochistic, linguistic, you're more like a mystic. The magic trick lives for me, die.
Thanks.
Super Bowl? How are you feeling? Huh? Feeling good? Are you feeling good? Are you feeling great? Are you feeling fucking awesome? I'm feeling fucking awesome. I've been to so many shows here, man. So many shows. I'm gonna let you guys in on a little secret, okay? I've been to so many shows here, and I've sat in all these different places and watched so many people perform here. It looks way fucking bigger from on stage. Way bigger. Scary bigger. I walked into soundcheck this morning, I said, nope, I'm going home. Can't do it. No way. I still get nervous all the time. I still get nervous. I get so nervous and my hands shake and I feel like I'm about to pee my pants. But I like you guys. I like you a lot and I have a feeling that over the course of this night, we're gonna transform a little bit together, okay? Now, Los Angeles is my home right now. But this next song is about where it all started for me. There's a place where the diamond would start, where a boy lives behind bricks. He's got an eye for brothers at 18, and he turns them on like tricks.
Sure. Thank you.
Maybe things will never be the same, but I'm not sure that I really loved the way they were before. And I don't know if I'm capable of loving anything anymore. My stomach's gaping open, I'm anxious to my knees. I toss and turn at night and hope that it's not a disease that is hereditary. Lord knows it's scary to think I might have made you into somebody like me. I wish that I could smile more, and maybe you would too. And I don't believe in anything unless I look at you. I know I should be better. I know that I should sleep. I know that it's imperative I get enough to eat. So why do I feel helpless when there's tons of help around? And why do I feel lost when I'm never left unfound? And maybe it's the internet or strangers at the store. I just feel like I don't belong here anymore. I'm sweeter than my mother, but stubborn as my dad. And I thought I'd be the person that the little me never had. The walls are caving in now, but somehow getting wider, and there's chaos and a never-ending silence, and there's cries that come from hunger and defiance. I'm a giant, and I'm lonely, but it's not you who's supposed to hold me.
Thank you.
So, I just started doing that on this tour. The whole drawing and singing thing. And, you know, most of my life, I used to feel really nervous about people watching me. Well, I mean, people just watching me in general, just like point blank. But also people watching me draw. I was one of those people where if you sat behind me in class and you looked over my shoulder, I got really self-conscious. And I stopped whatever I was doing, right? Woo, shout out being insecure as fuck! I really wanted to challenge myself on this tour. And I don't mean challenge myself because the art is complicated, because it's not, right? Like, I know some of you guys are in the audience being like, okay, cool, she did some squiggles, like, big fucking deal, Halsey. But that's exactly why I do it, right? Because I put an expectation on myself for a really long time that everything that I make has to be perfect. I used to get out on stage every single night and think to myself, if this show is not perfect, and my career will not live to see tomorrow. And that's a lot of anxiety to have walking out to stage. But I was wrong. Obviously I was wrong. Because I had a lot of bad shows. A ton. A lot of shows that weren't perfect. And you know, I'm here at the Hollywood Bowl, so I guess it worked out okay. Is about fucking up over and over and over and over again. And art is about letting, I don't know, 18,000 people see you suck at something, you know? I feel like every artist knows that. I feel like if every single time you put your pen to a paper, it's perfect, then you're not an artist, you're kind of just an asshole, you know? So, even though I knew in my gut that when I got up here and I did that little drawing, there would be a possibility that it fucking sucks. Because I do a different one every night, you know? I come out here and I draw something different, and that's pretty amazing because it means that what I put on that canvas is it's representative of this exact moment that we're sharing right now, right? It'll never be recreated, and I think there's something really cool about that. You know, I try really hard to keep my art super authentic. I'm really proud of you guys, Los Angeles, because usually by now, this is the part of the set where someone's like, shut the fuck up and sing! You guys are being very polite. Thank you. Thank you. Anyway. I think that art is about being authentic, right? And at the beginning of the set, I asked you guys a question up there on that screen, and I said, what matters more in a story, if it's good or if it's true? And every single night I come out here and I sing songs that are about a version of myself that was true at the time, but might not be anymore. So it makes me wonder, am I still being authentic? Am I still being true with you? I think so, right? There's a lot of songs that I'm gonna sing tonight that are songs I wrote in a really dark time in my life. And if you guys can relate to that, then I need you to make me a promise right now. I need you to make me a promise that when you're in here and you're singing and you're reliving those moments, that old you, that old truth, just like I'm doing right now, that when you leave here, you're gonna leave her, him, them here too. You're not gonna take that old person with you. Leave it on the floor with the confetti, man. Leave it on the floor with the confetti. Don't let them follow you home. You don't need them anymore. This one's a little fan favorite that I just wanted to play tonight. If you have a light on your phone, now would probably be a good time to bring it up. He said, please don't go away. Please don't go away. He said, please don't go away. He said, please don't go away. You guys sound beautiful. Are you sure? step. I got a few more tricks up my sleeve.
As your queen, I am allowed to behave in any way that I see fit. Does anybody know what time it is? I said, does anybody know what time it is? Darling, I've just left the bar. Misplaced all my credit cards. My self-preservation and all the mother's ambitions are sitting in the corner. Don't be doing me. Think I took you way too far. And I'm still
Damn, dude. You know, we were supposed to play here on the Manic Tour. Oh, Scott, hold on. I threw a pick and it... I'm not very athletic. There's a reason why I make music, and it's because I didn't make any sports teams growing up, so I learned violin instead. Actually, do you want to hear a really funny story? Okay. When I was really little, my mom really wanted to coach me on a softball team, which is adorable, but there was like one huge problem, and it was that I didn't give a fuck about softball at all. So my mom was the assistant coach for this team, and I was her kid, so I had to play on the team, obviously, right? Because otherwise, she's just some lady coaching a bunch of kids, you know, so I had to be there. So I pretty much just, like, dicked around during every single practice. Like, found a reason to stay home sick, was picking daisies in the grass or some shit, you know. And we had our first game ever. And it was my turn to go up to bat. And I hit the ball. It's fucking crazy, right? I hit the ball and the pitcher caught it. And I ran around all of the bases anyway. I feel like that says a lot about the person that I turned into. And they felt so bad for me because I was so excited. So they gave us the point anyway, you know? And there's a reason I'm telling that story. And it's because a couple months ago, I wrote a song. And I really loved this song and I really wanted to put it out. And I went up to bat. And I teed up that song. And I fucking hit it. And my label caught it. But it didn't matter. Because I ran around all those fucking bases anyway. And they had to give me the point. When I said ask for forgiveness, never permission, I meant that shit. Will you guys do me the honor of letting me sing my brand new song?
Yeah. It's really crazy looking in the audience and seeing so many people that I recognize. Not just like my friends and my family, but people who have been coming to my shows for years. People who were at my very first show at the Troubadour. It's kind of insane. I suffer from absolutely supreme imposter syndrome. Like sometimes I think that two guys in like black suits are gonna come up on the stage and like lift me up from under my shoulders and be like, hey, you weren't supposed to make it this far. You're going back to Jersey. Come on, kid. Come on. Like they're gonna pull me off the stage kicking and screaming. Like I'm gonna wake up one day back in New Jersey and I'm gonna look at my friends and my family and I'm gonna be like, I was playing the Hollywood Bowl. And they're gonna be like, all right, Ash, let's go to bed. Whatever you say. There's absolutely zero fucking reason why I should be here right now. So thank you guys so much. Thank you for letting me walk to this stage every single day and just think to myself, I have the best life in the world. I'm usually far more eloquent than this, but I'm honestly just kind of like a little speechless right now. I don't know what to say. But there are some things that I do have to say. It's very important that I say, so I'm gonna say them right now. I wanna take a second to introduce you guys to my band, okay? Because they're incredible. I don't have a whole lot of time, so I'm gonna have to keep this short, but over here on the keys, one of my favorite people in the entire world. She's amazing. Will you guys please give it up for Bonnie? And over here on guitar and bass, I headbutted the fuck out of her the other night and I feel so bad. Another one of my favorite people in the entire world. Will you guys please give it up for Liv? And over here on the drums, not one of my favorite people. He's okay, decent guy. I'm just kidding. Also one of my favorite people in the entire world on the drums. Will you guys please give it up for Harry? And supporting me tonight, the first act is a girl that I care about very, very, very much. She's supremely talented. She's only played a few shows so far, so I hope you guys were kind to her because she's incredible. She's gonna be huge. Will you guys please give it up for Abby Roberts? And then, the craziest thing in the world, somehow, got my favorite band ever to come play the show. Every night of the tour, I sit in my dressing room and I listen to their songs while I'm getting ready. And tonight I had the luxury of getting to listen to them play those songs live. And I couldn't believe it. Will you guys please give it up for legitimately my favorite band ever? Will you please give it up for Wolf Alice? And the unsung heroes of the show, the people who come here every single day and set up the stage, the lights, the sound, the video, the seats, who make all of this possible for you to experience. Will you guys please give it up for the crew? Every single person in this room, whether you're a fan, whether you're just here to check it out, whether you're some old guy who was like, oh, she worked with Trent Reznor, so I'll come see what the fuck is up. Or you got dragged along with your sister or your brother or your kid, whoever. Every single person in this room has played a part in why I get to be here today by listening, buying the tickets, supporting me. So thank you guys so much. Will you give it up for yourselves? this can go. I can either play like two more songs and then leave without doing any of the hits. Or I can play two more songs, pretend like I'm leaving, and you guys do the thing, you know, the thing that crowds do. And then I'll come back out and play those songs that you've been waiting all night to hear. It's gonna be up to you.
Sabotage the things I love the most. Yeah. some parts off with some scissors. Come on, little lady, give us a smile. No, I ain't got nothing to smile about. Got no one to smile for. I waited a while for a moment to say I don't owe you a goddamn thing. I keep on looking at the wreckage of my life. I gotta recognize the woman in my mind. They talk shit, but I love it every time. And I'm in love. No sweet dream, but I'm a hell of a night. And no sweet dream, but I'm a hell of a night.
You know, I didn't know what to expect tonight, but you guys have been a really, really cool fucking crowd. LA is always hard, man, and I know why LA is hard, because I'm part of the LA that is hard. I come to concerts and I'm too cool to dance, and I'm on my phone and I'm super fucking self-conscious the whole time, and every now and then when I'm in someone else's audience, I remember how that feels for me when I'm out looking at mine, and I try to let my guard down and have a little bit of fun, but you guys really surprised me tonight, so thank you for that. And my entire family is here, so it really means a lot that I get to see this. How many of you guys are in healthy relationships right now? In loving, healthy relationships? No, it's a crazy thing, because so am I. And I get on stage every night and I'm like, fuck this motherfucker who broke my heart. And then I go home to the most like loving and adoring partner ever. How many of you said you were in happy relationships? Okay. I'm gonna ask you to do me one more favor, okay? And then I won't ask anything else of you. You guys have already done enough. For the next 4 minutes, I need you to pretend like you're really fucking mad at your partner, okay? And I wanna believe it. I wanna believe it's so good that you guys fight in the car on the way home. I'm just kidding, no fight. And for the rest of you, I don't think you're gonna have any problem with this one.
I love you more.